Ang dami naming binasa tungkol sa Portrait of an Artist as a Filipino ng dakilang Nick Joaquin. Incidentally, this is the centenary of Nick, the national artist.
Correct.
Ang dami, 1951 it was written, 1952 it was published, may mga accounts 1955, may nagsasabing 1956. I mean, tell me what you know. Let's go to the genesis of the material.
Around the time also.
Around the 50s.
Around the time, yeah. And that at first it was heard on radio. That's what
See?
I know.
Wow. Okay.
Some parts of it on radio until finally the whole play was, and then finally
stage,
and then the film.
At sa Intramuros ginawa.
At sa Intramuros.
Okay. Yeah. The first staging of the play.
Yes.
At dinadayo ng mga sosyal nung araw ang Intramuros just to watch that production. Mm. Because nagkukwento nun si Direk Lamberto Avillana about.
Ah, wala ka pa doon?
Actually, I was the inspiration for Candida. I have to admit it now in public.
But nagkukwento si ang dakilang Lamberto, Avellana.
How life was there. Kasi noon, wala pa really professional theater.
Oh,
in fact, kailan nag-umpisa ang professional theater dito? Mga bandang 70s na.
Yeah, 50 years ago.
So, yun talagang sila ang nasa vanguard of getting something started.
Yeah. No, but the first production of Larawan, of Portrait, was staged by Barangay Theater Guild.
Yeah, na ni Direk Lamberto.
Lamberto Avellana, the great Daisy Avellana.
For the longest time, she ang lead lagi.
Of course, she was always there. Because it was not the great Nati Karami Rogers, but another actor, Olive Dolly Benavides, played it for a while. And then
you mean Paula?
Paula. Yeah. And then Nati Karami Rogers
became Paula. Yeah.
That's right.
Naging parang definitive Paula, actually.
Yes.
Why is it considered to be one, if not the most famous Filipino play?
Well, you know, the first time I was exposed to Larawan, it was the Filipino translation of Peta. So that was in the 70s. So when I saw it, it was Rita Gomez and Lolita Rodriguez.
Wala pa si Charito.
Wala pa. The first production in Peta of Larawan, Rita Gomez and Lolita Rodriguez. And I mean, I came away from that experience na kaganyan. Kasi,
gaping.
My God,
Rita was Candida.
Yes.
Lolita was Paula.
Rita was Candida.
Who played Tony Javier?
Let me see.
Armando Guyena.
Philip Salvador.
Doon sa original na Armando Guyena.
Armando Guyena.
Wow.
Yes. With Lolita Rodriguez.
No, on stage before that.
You're talking
of the Barangay Theater.
Yung kapanahonan ko.
Okay.
Nung ang mundo ay black and white pa.
Nung ako na, nung 70s,
may kulay na.
It was
psychedelic na.
Philip Salvador, if I remember.
Sila Mitch, you were part of the cast of Peta or of the...
Si Mitch.
Peta.
She was Susan.
Tama. I will
and Lordy Villanueva.
Tama.
Yeah.
Oh. Whoa!
Yeah.
It was
galeng, fabulous cast.
Ito yung pinanggagalingan kasi ng pelikula. I want people to realize
it. Leopoldo Salcedo and Dante Rivero were also in a production in Peta. The first production, I think.
Of Larawan?
You must have been Senator Perico.
Oh, something. I don't know. Something,
could be.
Which was then played by Coco Trinidad.
Doon sa original.
The original.
The original.
Dahil nung nakita ko si Noel.
Father
ni Noel.
Creepuson was even in the original kasama nila Lorley.
In Peta.
Peta production.
Ang pagkakaalam ko rin ay gumawa ng translation.
Maraming gumawa ng translation.
Marami.
Kasi I did also Larawan, the play for Tanghalang Pilipino. I was Candida. And it was another translation. I think that was Bien Lumbera.
So, while we're talking about this, bakit? Why the interest?
Why do we keep going back to it? It's our story. Why we are like this. We were before the war, we were elegant, we were having tertulias.
Yeah, Paris of Asia.
Yeah, we were Pearl of the Orient. And then we lost it all. So we keep going back to it because it tells us
parang
what
gusto ibalik.
We are. No, even if hindi mo na maibabalik because it's gone.
Yeah.
It's gone. But at least we can refer back to it and see, oh my goodness, we were such a wonderful people.
At sa akin, importante kasi yung bang binibigyan ang tema ng grupo namin, we come in at the last part of the musical, is we're saying we have to fight for the past, what's important about the heritage, because it's the only way we can understand the present and face the future with some kind of strength, some kind of solid sense of being who we are.